What's up, guys? How's it going? So welcome back to another video. I was just doing a little bit of work here on the laptop. This inverter I have, 300 watt inverter, it's working good. I can track my battery voltage, which is still above 12 volts, which is great. Charges the laptop just fine. It's a 300 watt inverter. To run a portable heater, I'd probably need about a 1500 watt.
This sucker's electrical, but I need a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity. 1.21
gigawatts! 1.21 gigawatts! Great Scott! What the hell is a gigawatt?
I could also get just one that runs off of butane or propane. So anyway, wanted to make this video because I was getting questions and Q&As and all this, and other people have done videos on topics like this, but about the sleeping situation, about where I shower, about a lot of things. Internet, hotspot, how does all that work, food. Well, as you guys know from the previous video, I bought that portable butane stove, which has worked great so far. All right, and then put the skillet on. But I might get one that's like, you know what I'm talking about, like it's like the flat one, not, this one's more for like heating up coffee or fixing things. And I mean, it's still, it works, you can balance it on there, but you know what I'm saying. But anyway, that's what I cook on.
If you smell, oh, what the rock,
otherwise I'll run to like a gas station, get a drink, if I'm really in a pinch or bind. I'll
enough whiskey and cold balls to get me in a bind. Amps juice the whole damn block could hit.
I'll get a snack or food.
Two packs of Marlboros, some snowballs, and a jumbo coke.
A lot of times I try to stock up at the grocery store and save a little bit of money in the long run. Like I say, every dollar you guys donate, it's reinvested back into the channel. And I got those links in the description box below, and I obviously appreciate all the support. As far as the sleeping situation goes, right now, you know, this is, what is today, like the 21st, right? So it's like the autumn equinox right now, first day of fall, basically.
You remember that total eclipse of the sun about a week ago?
Daddy. And the lows are around 50, 45 to 50. The highs are in the 70s. Next week might be like closer to 80-ish. As we get further along here, it's going to get colder. I have two sleeping bags. I have some jackets, including a couple 32-degree jackets. I have some sweats that I actually need to start wearing because my legs get a little chilly, especially when it gets, you know, 2, 3, 4 a.m., right before 5 a.m., right before the sun comes up. And, you know, of course, I try to get some sunlight every day. Sleeping overall is pretty good. Sometimes I'll even sleep in here. Like, I'll just recline the seat. I'll have a pillow on this, on either side of me. So if I kind of want to, like, roll, you know, I also have a neck pillow. And, you know, for some insulation, I'll put the sleeping bags, obviously, around my legs. But on this side of the door as well. The windows, I haven't bought that reflectic stuff yet. But I will, I'll put, like, I have enough extra jackets where I will drape it over the windows, like inside here, so you know there's a way to do that. I did that last night and it works out pretty well. Obviously I'll have the windshield covered and stuff. As far as where to sleep, they have a bunch of dispersed camping free campsites. You guys can look it up. They have plenty of apps that tell you where, and because you don't want to be spending money on a campsite. I mean, every once in a while is okay, I guess, if you know, as a luxury, or if you have the money and all that, which is great. But I like saving money, so I look for the dispersed, the free camping sites. Or you can even park in front of, now you gotta be careful, I haven't gotten any knocks on the windows yet about leaving. Obviously most Walmarts will, some are now are changing that policy. I know especially in the city there's certain ones where you'll get kicked out within, you know, pretty quick, the same night, obviously, you know, within a few hours. I've read some reviews on those, but anyway, like last night I actually slept outside of a hotel, in the truck. I parked, you just pull in, turn off the lights really quickly.
Thank you.
if you want to even go inside and use a restroom or whatever, you can do that. Or your local library. You only need the library card to check out books, but just to go in and browse, use their internet, their Wi-Fi. Me, I have a hotspot for my laptop and my phone, or I use my phone's hotspot, so that works great. Funny enough, not too long ago, I did the video on the Verizon home internet review and suspended it for now. It brings my bill down, and I don't really need it because I got my phone for the hotspot, and it, you know, there's free Wi-Fi. You can go to coffee shops. You can go to, again, libraries, a lot of places. And as far as showering goes, we'll go over that.
None of the fellas want to speak of her head. On their faces, they wear a silly smile.
Get out of here, you nosy little pervert, or I'm going to slap you silly.
Gym membership. Planet Fitness is $10 a month. Or any other gyms in your area. You know, I've spent anywhere from, like, right now, $10 a month at Planet Fitness. And they do have the $24.99 a month membership. When I was going to LA Fitness, that was $35 a month. EOS was $24.99 a month. So search around. They also have truck stops. They have portable showers. Hell, you can even use baby wipes if you're in a pinch. Yeah, I like the gym. That's my favorite. And truck stops are okay, but I believe sometimes those will cost money, like $12, whatever it is. It depends on the location. But as far as the gym, you can get in a workout, lift some weights, maybe do some cardio. I focus more on the weights because the cardio I can do outside. I can go hiking. I can walk around. Hell, if you're at your own campsite, you can just do calisthenics. You can do push-ups. You can do those called box jumps. You can, you know, where you use your legs and you jump up and all that. And get creative. So anyway, back to the sleeping thing. You probably don't want to stay in the same spot for too long as far as like many nights over, because you know people could potentially report it. Again, I haven't had that problem yet, but again, there's many apps. Check around where you're at, any free campsites and all that stuff. So yeah, other than that, I think that's about all I wanted to cover in this video. I was posted up on Instagram, and I'm working on a few things. I got a few things in the works. Meet up and hang out with my friend later, and maybe get some more stuff at Walmart or wherever. Yeah, that being said, though, I appreciate you guys. Thanks for watching. We're just getting started here. And again, if you guys can donate anything, $1, $5, $10, $50, just I have the links. They're all below, Cash App, Venmo, PayPal. And then if you can't, at least subscribe if you're new and like up the video. And if you're new to the channel, I'm kind of transitioning over to, I guess you could say, like, I'll do more videos on this in the future. But as far as, like, kind of full-time living, I wouldn't say off-grid. My great uncle's like, so you're going to go in the woods and hunt and kill your own food? Well, no. Buy food at the store and stuff. But don't get me wrong, I wouldn't mind going hunting, you know, elk hunting, or, you know, you can go bow hunting and stuff. I read Cameron Haynes' book, Endure, and a great book. So, yeah, getting some work done. I had some calls. Like, where I'm at right now, I got perfect service. I got charging up my laptop, so it's working out. I haven't bought a portable power station other than the battery jumper that I have. So if my battery dies for whatever reason, I do have jumper cables as well, but obviously you need another vehicle if you're using those. The jump box, which is, as of right now, 100%, 99% charged. By the way, I had that thing sitting in my car in the heat for like a year or two. Didn't really have to use it. And it was still at like 68% charge. And I jumped a battery on my old vehicle. And it only went down like a couple percentages. And right now, it charged up pretty quickly. And just turn it on and hook it up to your battery. And that's that. You can also use this to charge your phone. But it doesn't have any, like with the inverter, it doesn't have the household plug-ins. It just has USB. So potentially, that could be something that I'd be getting, is a portable power station with the solar panels. Solar panels are optional. Now, as far as the heat goes, again, I don't run the truck at night. The AC works great, but I don't run the heater or waste fuel unless if it was seriously cold and I had to. But I'd rather get, like, and obviously if you're getting a, well, first of all, I'd rather use sleeping bags and jackets and all that, but, and blankets. If you're going to be using a heater with, like, propane or butane or whatever, then you're going to want to get one or two carbon monoxide detectors, preferably two, just in case. And also, I would not run those overnight, okay? If you have to, but like, I would just run them before you go to bed for a little while, and then as soon as you're ready to go to sleep, you know, turn it off or unplug it, whatever. Just a few quick tips and updates and a Q&A that I wanted to get on here and do real quick, because getting the content rolling out to you guys. But thank you guys for watching. Follow me on Instagram if you haven't already. I will see you guys in the next one. Support the channel if you can. Subscribe if you're new, and I will see you guys. Keep on trucking. Peace.